Sizzling. Melania Trump holds Donald's hand as she arrives at concert for G7 leaders and their spouses in a custom Dolce & Gabbana gown, after donning the label's $51,500 jacket earlier in the day. It is the final day of Donald and Melania Trump's first official tour as President and First Lady, and it looks like 47-year-old Melania is eager to go out with a sartorial bang. After having made a chic arrival in Sicily, where her husband is attending a G7 summit, Melania stepped out Friday morning in the coastal town of Catania, making a very stylish statement in a $51,500 coat by Dolce & Gabbana, which was covered with colorful 3D flower embellishments, and came complete with a matching $1,630 purse by the Italian luxury label. However, the First Lady traded the statement coat for a shimmery, high-neck silver dress and equally sparkly $945 shoes by Dolce & Gabbana to attend a concert by the La Scala Philharmonic Orchestra at the ancient Greek theater of Taormina with her husband, President Trump, on Friday evening. Although the price of the one-of-a-kind dress is not known, made-to-order dresses from D&G's couture runway shows reportedly start at a minimum of $40,000. Melania looked radiant as she and Trump arrived hand-in-hand at the concert, which was attended by other G7 leaders, including France's new president, Emmanuel Macron. Macron gave a big smile when he shook hands with Melania, just one day after his awkward handshake with her husband. At their first meeting ahead of the NATO summit in Brussels on Thursday, the two leaders locked hands for so long that knuckles started turning white. Trump finally seemed ready to pull away, but Macron evidently wasn't. The French president held the shake for a few seconds more. Both men's jaws seemed to clench. Macron won France's election this month by positioning himself as the anti-Trump, embracing globalization and open borders and quoting philosophers. Despite the awkward moment, Trump and Macron's wives appeared to be getting along splendidly, and Brigitte stopped to chat with Melania and her husband before the concert. Brigitte, 64, looked elegant in a white military-inspired coat, a white skirt, and black pumps featuring silver toe caps that matched the silver buttons on her double-breasted jacket. France's First Lady paired her minimalist look with a black Louis Vuitton handbag after wearing a mini dress by the French luxury label the day before. While Melania has gone all out, wearing everything from a leather suit to a $51,500 floral coat during her first international trip, Brigitte has opted for more casual designs. On Thursday morning, Brigitte was photographed leaving the San Domenico Palace Hotel in Taormina, the venue of the annual G7 summit, in white skinny jeans, wedge espadrille sandals, and a red sweater. However, Melania ensured that all eyes would be on her Dolce & Gabbana coat when she arrived at Chiarissi Palace in Catania by opting to pair the quirky piece with a simple beige dress and heels by the same designer, adding a pair of sunglasses to protect her eyes against the bright sunshine. Her brunette hair, meanwhile, was left loose around her shoulders. While plenty of designers have refused to dress the First Lady over her husband's politics, Dolce & Gabbana has repeatedly supported Melania, who wore a blazer from the Italian label for her official White House portrait. Stefano Gabbana, one half of the famed duo behind Dolce & Gabbana, took to his personal Instagram on Friday morning to proudly share photos of Melania wearing the brand's exquisite floral coat. U.S. First Lady Melania Trump arrives for a visit at the Chiarissi Palace City Hall of Catania on the sidelines of a G7 summit of the heads of state and of government in Taormina, heart emoji, thank you at FLOTUS hash Melania Trump, he wrote. The images see Melania beaming at the waiting cameras as she made her way out of an SUV upon arrival at the Chiarissi Palace, where she and her fellow G7 spouses enjoyed a tour. Melania couldn't have looked happier as she made her way to join the rest of her group, despite a lengthy few days that have seen her completing several official engagements, while her husband President Trump has met with several world leaders. Trump and Melania are staying at the Belmond Grand Hotel Taimeo in Taormina, Italy, and on Thursday morning, she flew via helicopter to Catania. Melania took to Twitter during her flight to share a photo of the stunning view below, writing, "On my way to a lunch and MTGS as part of #G7. Taormina, 2, Catania #Italy." After Melania's stunning arrival at the Chiarissi Palace, she joined the G7 spouses at the town hall in Catania, where she waved to the people down below. The First Lady was photographed standing alongside Mayor of Catania Enzo Bianco, his partner Amanda Succai, Emmanuel Amaro, Joachim Sauer, and Malgorzata Tusk, looking happy as can be while smiling at the cameras. Certainly things seem to have been more enjoyable for the First Lady in the past few days, as evidenced by her public show of affection for her husband upon their arrival in Sicily on Thursday evening. After frostily batting his hand away earlier in the week, Melania held on tight to her husband as the pair made their way down the stairs of Air Force One and onto the runway at the Sigonella Air Force Base, before hopping into a waiting motorcade. For her flight to Sicily, Melania changed into her third outfit of the day, a strappy black cocktail dress with matching pumps which sported a cheeky leopard print sole, having spent the day showcasing two other chic ensembles, including a leather suit and a lacy black Dolce & Gabbana dress. Sicily is the final stop on the Trump's first foreign overseas tour. On Friday and Saturday, the president will meet with other G7 leaders at a summit in Taormina. The couple will also attend a G7 concert by La Scala Philharmonic Orchestra on Friday evening, and will join the other leaders and their partners for dinner. Their affectionate display disembarking Air Force One on Thursday evening came after Melania snubbed her husband on two separate, and very public, occasions as he tried to take her hand. The first was when the pair landed in Israel on Monday. The First Lady was filmed swatting his hand away as he reached back for hers as they made their way down a red carpet at the airport. The second was on Tuesday in Rome. Rather than take her husband's hand as he stretched out for hers, the First Lady fixed her hair as they emerged from Air Force One. Before her flight to Sicily on Thursday evening, Melania dazzled in Brussels wearing a leather skirt suit by Belgian designer Maison Nulens and Menlo Blahnik snakeskin heels to visit a children's hospital before meeting a group of NATO spouses, including France's new First Lady, to tour the Magritte Museum. Meanwhile, France's First Lady was the epitome of chic in a black Louis Vuitton frock, as she joined Melania and other NATO spouses, on a private tour of the Magritte Museum, which is devoted to the works of Belgian surrealist painter René Magritte. Amelia de Baudrengian, partner of Belgian Prime Minister Charles-Michel Gauthier d'Estaing, the husband of Luxembourg's gay prime minister, and Emine Erdogan, the devoutly Muslim wife of Tayyip Erdogan, president of Turkey, were also on the tour. Famed for works like the 1964 self-portrait of a bowler-hatted man whose face is hidden by an apple or the image of a pipe subtitled Ceci n'est pas un pipe, this is not a pipe, Magritte has much to teach the world about questioning outward appearances, and about self-effacement, Belgian organizers said. You never know, museum director Michel Draguet said ahead of Melania's visit. Maybe Donald Trump will move from one kind of surrealism to another, thanks to Magritte's ideas. After their trip to the museum, the NATO spouses enjoyed an evening at the Royal Castle of Ulken, the royal residence of Brussels King Philippe and Queen Mathilde. Although Brigitte and a few other women opted to leave on what they wore to the museum, Melania slipped on an off-the-shoulder black lace gown and scrappy stiletto sandals by Dolce & Gabbana before rejoining the rest of the group at the royal residence. Melania was all smiles. She posed for pictures with group at the castle, which is located near Brussels. However, she wasn't the only one to change her outfit for the night's festivities. Ingrid Schuylerjord, whose husband is Jens Stoltenberg, Secretary General of NATO, traded her black frock and cardigan from earlier in the day for an electric blue dress. During their visit to the castle, the group was given a tour of by Queen Mathilde, who was pictured escorting them around a lush-looking garden, walking alongside Melania and Ingrid. Before she met up with the other spouses on Thursday, Melania visited the Queen Fabiola Children's Hospital in Brussels, where she spent time doing arts and crafts with the young patients. She happily took selfies with the children while presenting them with several gifts, including Dr. Seuss books and souvenirs from the White House. Melania was presented a bouquet of paper flowers during her visit, and she graciously gave one to each child before posing for photos with them. It was Melania's second trip to a children's hospital during her and her husband's international tour. The First Lady also visited Vatican's Children's Hospital on Wednesday during her trip to Italy, and much like her trip to the hospital in Brussels, she met with patients, painted pictures with them, and took selfies.